India, after splitting from Gondwana, journeyed northward and collided with Asia around 50 million years ago. This colossal impact gave rise to the Himalayas, the tallest mountain range on Earth. But to understand how this happened, let's go even further back in time to discover, how did the continents form? Time travel, a different Earth. Imagine traveling back hundreds of millions of years. The world map would look completely different. No Americas, no Africa, no Europe. Just one massive landmass surrounded by a vast ocean. This was the Earth during the era of a supercontinent called Pangaea. One land, one ocean. Pangaea formed around 335 million years ago, uniting nearly all of Earth's landmasses. It was encircled by a gigantic ocean called Panthalassa. Life on Pangaea was mostly concentrated inland, where the climate was dry and desert-like. Moving plates, the hidden force. So what made this colossal continent break apart? The answer lies deep beneath the Earth's surface, in the movement of tectonic plates. The Earth's crust isn't solid and uniform. It's made up of several large and many smaller plates that float slowly on the semi-fluid mantle. These movements are driven by heat from the planet's core. Laurasia and Gondwana, the first split. About 200 million years ago, Pangaea began to crack. This led to the formation of two massive landmasses, Laurasia in the north and Gondwana in the south. These would later split further, giving rise to the continents we know today. Africa, South America, Antarctica, India, and Australia came from Gondwana. Europe, Asia, and North America emerged from Laurasia. These shifts had a massive impact on the evolution of life, climate, and global geography. Continental collisions, the Himalayas. For example, after breaking off Gondwana, India drifted northward and collided with Asia about 50 million years ago. This collision created the Himalayas, the tallest mountains on Earth. Continents in motion. Here's the most surprising part. Continental movement hasn't stopped. Continents are still shifting. For instance, North America is drifting away from Europe at about 1 inch per year. Some land masses are moving toward each other. Australia is heading toward Asia, and Africa is pressing into Europe, which could one day close the Mediterranean Sea. Future, a new supercontinent? What's next? Scientists predict that in 200 to 300 million years, a new supercontinent might form, often called Pangaea Proxima, or Novo Pangaea. Once again, Earth's map would look entirely different. Conclusion: Earth in constant change. Earth is never still. Continents are like slow dancers, endlessly shifting and reshaping the planet. Though these changes happen over millions of years, their impact is profound. So next time you look at a world map, think of it as just one frame in an endless geological movie. Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more mind-blowing facts.